commemorating the state birds of our proud nation.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
19 years ago, we thought, wow, how is there no way to tell the good from the bad? So we gave people the power of the review. And now Angie's List is revolutionizing local service again. You can easily buy and schedule services from top-rated providers. Conveniently stay up to date on progress and effortlessly turn your photos into finished projects with our SnapFix app. Visit AngiesList.com today.
Can you start tomorrow?
Tomorrow, we're booked solid.
We close on the house tomorrow.
Tomorrow, we go live, everybody.
It's a day full of promise. And often, that day arrives by train.
Big day today?
Even bigger one tomorrow.
CSX, how tomorrow moves.
It's crazy at our house for the holidays. Everybody shows up.
We shop at Burlington because we're getting the kids ready, we're getting the house ready.
Great prices, dresses, shoes, wine glasses. I got everything at Burlington. Amazing.
Next time you feel pain and stiffness, absorb this, Absorbine Plus. They call it that because its special formula is absorbed so fast to kill the pain and increase circulation to where it needs to be. Absorbine Plus relieves pain and stiffness. Absorb that.
With the wrong wiper blades, you could be on the road to trouble. But with Michelin Stealth wiper blades, with industry-leading SmartFlex technology and clog-free Smart Hinge exterior, you can see clear for the road ahead. Michelin Stealth, a better way forward.
Guess what? The brand new season of...
Oh, my God.
The brand new season of American Dad is...
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Okay, we got it. The brand new season of American Dad is on...
Oh, my God.
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 The brand new season of American Dad is on TBS.
Oh.
Yeah, you could say we're excited.
They said I wasn't good enough for TBS. How do you like me now, voices in my head?
Catch the brand new, edgier season Mondays at 9, 8 Central. Only on TBS and the Watch TBS app.
Call Humana now at 1-866-680-4971.
All day today, a Weather Channel first, the Winter Weather Prep Rally, a day dedicated to prepping and surviving winter's worst.
Best advice, try not to travel.
In the morning,
you've got our winter weather outlook.
And at night,
this is an incredibly deadly time of year.
Yeah, it's brutal.
The Winter Weather Prep Rally continues all day on the Weather Channel.
Hey, get ready for seven-day delivery, not free delivery, seven-day delivery this holiday season. The Postal Service expects 550 million packages this year, so they're going to deliver them even on Sunday. And another sign of the holiday season, four of this year's holiday stamps will feature Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. The animated TV special appeared for the first time 50 years ago on this date. Time to head out to the lab. Here's Alex.
And Dr. Postel wanted to be a dentist, like Herbie. No, I'm just kidding. I'm making that up. But Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, quite a classic.
And classic.
Getting us in the spirit. You know what else is going to get us in the holiday spirit?
The cold.
The cold.
How do you think about that? Look, New York City. This is our forecast for the next couple of weeks, actually from the European model. And what I want you to take away from this graphic is that it's going to get cold early next week and probably stick around cold for a little while longer.
Because you notice the dates, they keep scrolling, but those temperatures don't really rise.
There's the date, 11-9. So that's like November 10th. So this is probably early next week.
Mm-hmm.
And the temperature, we think, is going to take a dive into the below normal category and probably stay there through at least the 20th, maybe longer. We'll see how long. So that's a week to 10 days worth of below average temperatures, and not by a little, by a lot. And I put some shades on here to show you that those are kind of the ranges of what the other models are telling us, and there's a lot of weight down below this line. So there's a pretty good consensus that cold is going to stick around for a while in New York. You might as well substitute in a whole bunch of other cities, right? We were talking about that.
You said last hour that we could really say anything east of the Mississippi. So New York, Atlanta, Chicago, all these spots are going to stay cold, or get cold and stay cold. And it's got a Pacific connection. This is what's unbelievable. We're out in the Western Pacific, that once super typhoon, Nori, is going to have some play in this.
Yeah, it's actually, you know, even having some play right now. This is last Sunday. It was a super typhoon, very powerful one. It's among the strongest we've seen on the planet in recent years. And over the past few days, it's moved northward. It's a lot weaker now in terms of a tropical system, but it's made the jet stream wicked strong. In fact, there are some 200-mile-per-hour winds at high altitudes at the jet stream level inside of that flow that's moving all the way across the Pacific. And that's got to have an impact on our weather already.
Right. Downstream, because we're looking at big amplification in that jet stream. Yep. Also, it's going to lead to a pretty epic storm for the Aleutians.
Saturday, over the weekend, we're going to see a monster winter storm, which has some direct connection to the remnants of Nuri, and it's also got some of that jet stream energy together. So when you blend those together, you get a big storm out there. In terms of sea level pressure, pressure's down to somewhere in the 920s. If you think about that, that is about as strong as they can get, really, in this part of the world, and it's right up there with the strongest we've really ever seen in the modern record. So,
right, and you mentioned now we're talking wind, and we're talking big serious waves with this as well.
Right, we're going to have big winds all across the North Pacific, and this is a very broad view, really, from Alaska to Russia. So this is covering the entire North Pacific with giant winds there, 60 to 75 mile per hour sustained winds in places. And of course, that with a very long fetch is going to kick up some huge waves way over 45 feet, maybe some of them approaching 100 feet. I've read some of the discussions. So
right.
This is a monster wave producing system out there.
So pretty incredible stuff for them. If you are in the continental U.S., the east, you're thinking, all right, well, still, how is this connected to
me? How could it possibly do that? Well, like many other cyclones that do the same thing, this one will just have a bigger impact because it's so much bigger and stronger. But what they do is these systems, when they're in that part of the world, they throw a lot of warm air northward like that, north of the Arctic Circle, and they shove the Arctic air off its resting place and bring it down, deliver it down into North America, which is what we're going to see next week. Arctic high is going to be sliding down, and that Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I think, is even kind of just the beginning
right.
of a long stretch. We saw that time series in the beginning, right? It's
going
to last for
exactly.
a lot longer
going
than
all
this.
The way towards mid, even late month. So as you said, what we're seeing next Tuesday, next Wednesday with all those blues expanding might just be the beginning.
Yeah, and it's going to get a lot colder in the south. Guys, stay tuned toward the end of next week.
All right, good stuff. Thanks, Dr. Postel. Mm-hmm. Dave, back to you.
Hey, thank you, guys. Well, we're tracking more than winter weather threats. Tornado caught on tape, and what makes this spinning fury even more stunning? Where it struck. We'll show you more video and tell you where this was as Weather Center Live continues in just 60 seconds.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 65. Winds light and variable. Friday, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 79. Winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Friday night, a few clouds, low 64. Winds north-northeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
From the Weather Channel headquarters in Atlanta, you are watching Weather Center Live.
And welcome. I'm Dave Schwartz.
And I'm Alex Wilson. It is the largest storm on the planet right now, a fierce bomb of a storm taking aim on the Aleutians.
So what does that have to do with us? Well, it's going to reconfigure the flow of the atmosphere
that
will break. Let's see that again.
I like that.
Right. That will allow cold air sitting over northwest mm-hmm. Canada to make the move southward into the lower 48. Storm specialist Dr. Greg Postel.
He can help us.
He is live in the lab.
He is connecting those
dots.
Those
are some pretty good moves, Alex.
Thank you. That's what I assumed. assume the atmosphere is doing, right?
Yeah, my mind is still stuck on those. Okay, so let's now have a look at how cold it's going to get over the next couple of weeks across the U.S. And Chicago is just one city, but pretty much anywhere east of the Rockies, beginning, say, early next week, it's going to get cold and it's going to stick around. Let's have a look at the forecast for Chicago, for example. And here we go. This is the date on the bottom. So going through November, about through the 20th or so of the month. Up here, it's warmer than average. Here, it's colder. And this is the forecast. So we're going to be bobbing and weaving around the normal for the next couple of days, the average. And then by about the 10th, that would be early next week, it's going to take a dive in Chicago, get really, really cold, the coldest air of the season, and then probably stick around for a while, maybe a week, maybe 10 days, maybe even a little bit more than that. And what I shaded here is the sort of the other models' forecast, and you can see that there's a lot of weighting down there. So no matter what model you run, whatever, there's a lot of consensus there for below average temperatures on an extended period. Again, it could include New York, it could be Nashville, it could be Atlanta, you name it, Denver. Here's one of the reasons why. We have to go back to the Pacific and what happens out there, because that, as you guys were mentioning, Alex and Dave, has a lot to do with our weather here in North America. This weekend, we're going to have a monster storm, big one. It's got connections to Super Typhoon Nuri a few days ago, and it's got connections with a very strong jet stream already in place. Those two bundles of energy are going to wrap up and make one big storm out here that is going to be as strong by some measures as pretty much any we've really ever seen in this part of the world, at least in the modern record. So that going on, what it does is kind of change the pattern of the jet stream a little bit, because it sends warm air on the east side of it way north. And when you do that, imagine that. Imagine sending all this warm Pacific air northward to places where it's normally really cold. Well, that cold air, it's got to go somewhere, right? So it goes south. It gets pushed off those higher latitudes and then slides south. This is classic Arctic outbreak. I mean, this is just one big time example, but this happens anytime, really, we get a very cold outbreak in the U.S. One of these storms is in that spot, but this one just happens to be a really big one, and it's going to set up some wicked cold air, certainly November style, no doubt about that. Look at some of these numbers next Monday. And again, this is just the beginning of it, because it's going to last days upon days. Tuesday, look at some of these numbers. Pick your favorite spot. Those blues, those below averages, they expand on Wednesday, and it's going to get even more so on Thursday, even in the south. These numbers are going to go down Thursday and Friday by a long shot. Florida, you're not out of the woods. It's going to get really cold for you as well. Alex, back to you.
All right. Turn on those heaters. Make sure they're working again. Use them safely, though. Of course, that's part of Prep Rally today. We're looking at Niagara Falls, one of the spots that's going to feel the chill next week. And to end this week, see some snowflakes flying. Not much out there right now, but parts of the Northeast have seen rain, and that's the way this system is starting up. Late week storm affecting the Great Lakes over to the Northeast. And as I said, right now, it's mainly rain that you're seeing. This is just off towards the east of Rochester, so over towards, say, the Victor area. Syracuse, you're seeing a little bit of a let up now, but some of that heavy rain up 81 towards Watertown, also towards the east of Interstate 81, say east of Cortland. Jamestown, Bradford, you've still seen some light to moderate rain showers continue. And as we look at the big picture, it is mostly rain that we're seeing across parts of the Northeast, even Mid-Atlantic right now. But we will see that transition from rain to snow as we go through the overnight and then into the day tomorrow. Winter alerts in play. We've got a winter storm warning into northern Maine. That's where most of the rain or snow is going to come falling. Winter weather advisories, winter storm watches in other parts of the Northeast and New England. So tonight, we begin to see that pink blend in. So that's where the rain and snow will be mixed. By tomorrow, plenty of areas in blue, meaning all snow showers for you, primarily northern sections of New England. That's where I think we'll see the most significant accumulations. Remember, Maine, you just got the power back after snow from last week's system, 8 to 12 inches possible up towards Caribou. Northern sections of New Hampshire, Vermont, New York, 1 to 3 inches will be possible. Even 1 to 3 inches into a bit of central and western New York, Dave.
Well, the hot spot in the United States right now, Fullerton, California, 92. Now, they're not going to feel this new Arctic blast that's on the way. But if you live east of the Rockies, you will. So now is the time to get ready for winter and get your pets ready, too. And we're helping you do that, courtesy of our winter prep rally, which we're holding. Kate Parker, our Weather Channel therapy dog butler, and his trainer share the top five things needed to do to protect your pet this winter.
In the winter, we like to stay inside as much as possible, but the one member of our family that can't avoid going outdoors are our furry friends. So that's why Butler, our Weather Channel therapy dog, is here to help us count down your top five winter pet care tips. Number five, create a pet emergency kit.
So we have Butler's cold weather emergency kit here. It's well stocked and ready to go in case we have a power outage or can't leave the house for a few days. We have Butler's favorite, his food bowl. An emergency kit should have 3 days of his medication, water, and of course his favorite food.
Number four, beware of salt and antifreeze.
Many people use powerful chemicals to guard against ice buildup on their sidewalks. And those chemicals can be very toxic to dogs. So once your dog comes in from playing outside, it's important to wipe down their paws and their abdomen. Antifreeze is very sweet tasting to dogs, so you want to look for the kind that has propylene glycol as opposed to ethylene glycol.
Number three, watch out for frostbite.
So when your dog comes inside, check their ears, check their paws, check their tail. Frostbitten skin can appear pale or gray.
Number two, keep track of your pets.
When there's lots of snow on the ground, pets can become disoriented, so it's important to keep them on a leash.
And the number one winter pet care tip, give them shelter, even if they're outside animals.
Just because your pet has fur doesn't mean they can withstand cold temperatures. But a good rule of thumb is that if you're cold enough to come inside, your pet probably is too.
With these precautions, you and your pet can enjoy the cold and snow just as much as Butler. I'm meteorologist Kate Parker, the Weather Channel.
The doggies.
Ben and Riley say enjoy the snow. I'm going back to bed. You enjoy it, Mom.
Whatever.
Hi, I'm Jay Farner, president of Quicken Loans, and we're here in Detroit with our amazing team members. Let's meet some of them. People have heard a lot about HARP, but what's HARP?
It is the Home Affordable Refinance Program, and it is a government program that lets homeowners refinance if their home is underwater.
The average savings for one of our HARP programs is about $250 a month, which is a nice chunk of change.
Tell us about the HARP program. How does it work?
All you do is you call Quicken Loans for a free mortgage review.
Okay.
We figure out what we can do for you, and if you're in a good spot, we'll let you know immediately.
Okay. And we're going to walk you through your options. We're going to customize that solution based on exactly what your individual needs are.
And for the fourth year in a row, J.D. Power has ranked Quicken Loans highest in the nation in customer satisfaction.
What makes the HARP program so special?
It's a really easy process. From start to finish, we're doing it in 30 days. There's usually less paperwork. Very often, they don't even need an appraisal. It's easy.
Call Quicken Loans today for a mortgage experience that's engineered to amaze.
This week on Weather Channel Mornings, record lows in the east, our first major snowstorm out west, and we're tracking a storm that could affect travel plans for millions. Live team coverage from North Carolina to New England. Watch Wake Up with Al and AMHQ with Sam Champion. This week, only on the Weather Channel Mornings.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 65. Winds light and variable. Friday, sunshine and cloud. Friday night, a few clouds, low 64. Winds north-northeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Today, a Weather Channel first, the Winter Weather Prep Rally, a day dedicated to prepping and surviving winter's worst.
Best advice, try not to travel.
In the morning,
you've got our winter weather outlook.
And at night,
this is an incredibly deadly time of year.
Yeah, it's brutal.
The Winter Weather Prep Rally continues all day on the Weather Channel.
Breath freshening, cooling crystals, icebreakers.
What if you could get the performance you'd expect from a full-size music system without the complexity of a full-size music system? Presenting the Wave Music System 3 from Bose. It's engineered with exclusive waveguide speaker technology, allowing this small system to outperform many larger, more expensive stereos. And it includes convenient features like easy-to-use touch-top controls, an improved digital tuner for even better AM/FM reception. Plus, you can set two different wake-up times and gently wake up to your favorite music. Add accessories, and this versatile system lets you listen to your iPod or iPhone and charge it at the same time, or enjoy hours of your CDs uninterrupted. You'll even save $50 when you order the Wave Music System 3 by December 31st. Plus, receive free shipping to your door, so you can hear it risk-free for 30 days in your home. Be sure to ask about 6 easy payments with no interest charges from Bose. The Wave Music System 3. Simplicity, elegance, and performance. Only from Bose.
Happy Thursday, Houston. Kind of a gloomy day with the cloud cover, but not much rain for you guys. That's all to your neighbors to the south. Brownsville, you're in for a soaking as we wrap up the week. It's Gulf Coast rain that sticks with us into the weekend, so these are going to be the areas that are especially soggy today, tomorrow, even into the weekend. We were talking about Florida getting in on some of that rain, but right now it's mainly parts of South Texas, Corpus Christi, all the way down towards Brownsville. Now you see most of the steadier, heavier rain is on the same latitudinal scale as Corpus Christi. Brownsville, that's where you've got some of those showers scattered about. Corpus Christi, here's your forecast into tomorrow morning. We've got rain, 4, rain, 6, 8 o'clock. It lightens up a bit. Showers then as we head into the overnight. So you'll notice less of that pitter-patter of raindrops on the rooftop as you head into the overnight hours. Here's the radar showing most of the rain focused into this part of the state, and that's where it's going to stay, even though we'd love to see it further up to the north. When we look at the drought monitor, you can see the real extreme or severe drought focused in the north central part of the state of Texas, actually where we're seeing a lot of this rain, not necessarily the spot that needs it the most. But showers in the forecast around Corpus Christi tonight with the steadier, heavier rain further off to the south. Tomorrow, same story with the rain staying steady in places like Brownsville. So a little bit of a dreary end to the week. Not quite a washout, but you get the picture. Not a great day to be outside. If the kids have any kind of after school practices for any sports, they might be called off. As far as rainfall totals go, 2 to 3 inches, possibly more down around Brownsville, 1 to 2 inches between Brownsville and Corpus Christi. Dave.
Okay, it's geek alert. Are there any geeks in the house? Get them in here. Get them into the room. Yes, and you could run here too, Alex. We're about to roll some video from Italy of a tornado.
This, I'm not missing this.
Yes. All right, let's roll it. This is video of a tornado right across the street. Man, get away from the window.
Holy
look at
look
that.
Look at all that debris. And he's standing in front of a big glass window, as you've been pointing out.
Yeah. Look at that stuff. It's just mincemeat for a tornado. Rising, swirling. Those winds at least, that's at least an EF1, I would think. And he turns around and there he is. Debris has hit the window.
Mm-hmm.
So that cracked. Fortunately, it didn't shatter the window. But look at that, it's still swirling around. The tornado appears to be moving off to the right. We can see a lowering, the darkening of the clouds out there. But this was online, we had to show it to you.
Yeah.
I saw this 5 times, I just kept replaying it from home last night.
You know, amazing stuff, and as you've been pointing out, it almost looks like a showroom or something, but
yeah,
surrounded by glass. This part of the world, not necessarily as used to tornadoes as, say, parts of the South and the plains in the U.S., but use this as an idea of why this is not where you want to be, because as you mentioned, look at that giant crack.
There's the crack.
If you had more of that debris swirling around with this, it could have been a whole different story.
That's the thing. You know, it's not just the wind. You think, oh, I can handle the wind. I stand in front of the wind. But if the wind is throwing around pieces of metal,
perhaps your
body can't handle that
exactly.
As well. Well, this is Presto Flow. That's the next thing we're getting into.
That sounds like a buy on the phone product for your house.
Oh, yeah. And you'll see what happens when he loses a rap battle with Mother Nature.
Uh-oh.
This is just in.
There's confidence. Then there's trusting your vehicle maintenance to Ford Service confidence. Our expertise, technology, and high-quality parts mean your peace of mind. It's no wonder last year we sold over 3 million tires. And during the big tire event, get up to $140 in mail-in rebates on 4 select tires.
17 billion toilet paper tubes are thrown away in the U.S. alone. That's enough to fill the Empire State Building twice. Now there's Scott Naturals tube-free bath tissue. Get the premium softness you need without the wasteful tube. Toss the tube for good with Scott Naturals tube-free.
Hurry, there's a hot offer for heartburn sufferers. Now try Zantac free at ZantacOffers.com. Hurry, it's free this week only. No pill relieves heartburn faster. Get Zantac free at ZantacOffers.com.
Nature Valley Crunchy Granola Bars give you energy from one-third of your daily whole grains. So one-third of this commercial is dedicated to what you could do with all that energy. Energy to take the road less traveled.
Let's get a head start on the holidays. Let's open something before Christmas. Not that. Those. And of course, a whole lot of these. Let's make merry, along with a few other things. Deck out that. Save all these and spread more of this. That's how to holiday. Let's do this. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Trade in your old lights and get up to $5 off the latest LEDs.
See this? It shows the pressure points on my tired, achy feet.
I had no clue I was putting this kind of stress on my feet.
I have flat feet. I found this out at the free Dr. Scholl's Foot Mapping Center at Walmart. In less than 2 minutes, I got my foot map and my custom number. I'm a 440.
I'm a 210.
340.
That number matched the Dr. Scholl's custom fit orthotic inserts with just the right support to help relieve stress on my feet. I'm a believer.
Go to drscholls.com for locations and save $10.
This fall, you've got to watch the Weather Channel mornings.
It will all start with the weather.
The weather's too important to cover in a few minutes.
It's starting to intensify.
Because it's not just about your forecast.
Look at this.
Watching the NFL on Xfinity from Comcast is like having the best seat in the house on game day. Because NFL Red Zone gives you a front row seat to the biggest plays around the league. Including every touchdown from every game Sunday afternoons, live, all on one channel. Get NFL Red Zone from NFL Network when you add the sports entertainment package for just $4.99 more a month for 12 months. Xfinity, your home for the most live sports. Visit Comcast.com/NFL today.
A ballpark flame grill patty with the guys. Can it get any more American? Boom. Made with 100% beef, bold, juicy, ready in about a minute. Flame grilled freedom.
Eczema can just really put a damper on a lot of things. Constant itching and scratching. I'm not myself.
Gold Bond Eczema Relief Cream. Used daily, it's proven to relieve 5 frustrating symptoms of eczema.
Gold Bond Eczema Relief really works.
Weebly makes it easy for you to create one. Weebly, let's start something.
Day today, a Weather Channel first, the Winter Weather Prep Rally, a day dedicated to prepping and surviving winter's worst.
Best advice, try not to travel.
In the morning,
you've got our winter weather outlook.
And at night,
this is an incredibly deadly time of year.
Yeah, it's brutal.
The Winter Weather Prep Rally continues all day on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 80 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 65. Winds light and variable. Friday, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 79. Winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Friday night, a few clouds, low 64. Winds north-northeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Well, might be the video of the day. Rapper Presto Flo got a little too close to the water during a photo shoot. Mother Nature took care of the rest.
Wow. Oh.
See, now take a step back there, Presto.
No.
Should we have phoned that in to the Storm Prediction Center?
Presto soggy.
The sad part about it was there's an oyster bed right there, so he got cut up. He did.
Really?
I was reading the article. He got cut up in his hands. They took him to the ER, but he was back in the recording studio that night, so it wasn't serious. But how about that? Now he's a star on the Weather Channel.
I never know when you're serious. How about that? Well, I would like to think that now he's like, hey, all right, I had to fall. I had to embarrass myself a little bit, but I made it on the Weather Channel.
And I'd like you to start taking me seriously.
Is this one of his is this his
promotional
flow? Is this his flow plan?
Oh, is this his flow? It could be. It could be. He's trying to explain that to you right now.
I like it.
Yeah.
I feel the beat.
You see the hat on my head? One, two, three.
Well,
it's
that
gone.
Just shows, you know, once the hat got, he was like, I got to save the hat. Mm-hmm. Didn't work out so well.
His
I know is jamming to this flow?
What's that? Who?
Dr. Greg Postel.
Well, he's a big rap fan.
Yeah.
Greg?
Have you heard his rhymes?
No, but I'm. No, look at this video. Look, help me out with this video. Where did that wind gust come from? Look at the waves. They're going from right to left on this picture, right?
Yeah.
And they're not that strong.
True.
And all of a sudden, where does it even show up on the water? I mean, maybe they're protected.
Did he have a wind machine?
I think there's a wind machine behind him, and it's a hoax.
See, it's a publicity stunt.
Oh,
is what
no.
That is the most skeptical, disgusting.
First Alex from Target. Then the Red Bull Flair guys. You're about to tell me I'm about to get my third hoax of the week?
No,
I have this.
I have no idea. I don't want to get in trouble.
I do think you're onto something, though. It does look like behind the photographer, especially, those winds are really kicking there.
I think you guys want to take this disagreement out back here during the commercial.
I think we're going to do CSI weather videos.
Yeah, I'm with you. That looks good. But anyway, he got what he fell in the water, and you said there was an oyster bed there.
There was an oyster bed, so yeah, there was.
Oh, bummer.
He got caught, unfortunately.
Yeah, well. Better days ahead, I guess.
He has
right?
some awesome rapper quality Band-Aids.
Very good. Let's have a look at some winter weather coming to parts of northern New England over the next really 24 hours or so. We have winter storm warning and watches up there in northern Maine, New York, Vermont, and far northern New Hampshire there. This is the system that's really going to be associated with that snow. It's kind of swirling around there in the water vapor image, which, you know, shows us a bunch of things where it's moist and where it's dry at high altitudes, but it also gives you an idea of the flavor of the motions, because you see that swirl there, the counterclockwise thing going on there in the parts of the Ohio Valley. Well, that is an upper-level low, and there's a surface low underneath that, too. But right now, it's primarily a rainstorm. I mean, look at the radar. You see all these greens. It's rain. It's cold, 30s and 40s in Wisconsin and Michigan. So it's not like a warm rain, but it's rain. But that's going to change, I think, as we head forward to tonight and tomorrow. This thing is going to gradually morph into more of a snow event across parts of northern New England. Of course, farther to the south in Boston and New York and even Albany, you'll probably get away with basically no snow, maybe some flakes here and there. But D.C., all rain. You don't have to worry about it. This is a northern New England event. And let's have a look at some how this evolves. And then the numbers that come out of it in terms of snowfall accumulations, pretty high in northern Maine, but that's about it. Everywhere else, I mean, no big deal, right? So there's some snow in some of the higher elevations of the Adirondacks, the Green and White Mountains of Vermont and New Hampshire, and of course in northern Maine. But Caribou, Maine, Presque Isle, Houlton, Maine, you guys have gotten a lot of snow so far this year. Let us look at Bangor, Maine. That's a little bit farther south. They've already had 12 inches of snow this year, averaging 2.3. So it's been snowy times up in Maine and in Caribou, where they're going to get probably, you know, we saw 5 to 8 inches, maybe more. They've already had 11.8, and their average is less than that. So this is going to add to, I think, some snowy times up there, guys. And that's my last graphic. So I'm going to send it back to you, Alex and Dave, and maybe we can talk more about this rapper who fell in the water.
Yeah, maybe we could jam more to his
How about
his
that Dr. Greg Postel, huh?
He's fantastic.
Tossed to us with, like, 45 seconds to go.
What do you guys want to talk about?
On the clock. Can we cut his mic?
What? Can you guys hear me? Everybody's mic today.
Can you guys hear me? We can talk about whatever you'd like to. Can you hear me now?
There you go. What do you want to ask him?
Let's talk about getting a car ready for winter.
Oh, look at after all that, Dr. Postel. He gave you so much.
Yeah? What did he ask me again?
And then he goes to the tees.
Oh, nice. All right, so basically it's not just your car that you have to get ready for winter?
No, it's
is
not.
Is that right? What is
no.
it? Tell
exactly.
us.
You need to be ready, too, and sooner than some of you might think. Right, Greg?
Right.
That's how we do it. High five.
Thank you. was to finally get in shape. Not to be focusing again on my moderate to severe chronic plaque psoriasis. So I finally made a decision to talk to my dermatologist about Humira. Humira works inside my body to target and help block a specific source of inflammation that contributes to my symptoms. In clinical trials, most adults with moderate to severe plaque psoriasis saw 75% skin clearance on Humira. And the majority of people were clear or almost clear in just 4 months.
Humira can lower your ability to fight infections, including tuberculosis. Serious, sometimes fatal infections and cancers, including lymphoma, have happened, as have blood, liver, and nervous system problems, serious allergic reactions, and new or worsening heart failure. Before treatment, get tested for TB. Tell your doctor if you've been to areas where certain fungal infections are common, and if you've had TB, hepatitis B, are prone to infections, or have flu-like symptoms or sores. Don't start Humira if you have an infection.
Set a new goal today. Ask your dermatologist about Humira, because with Humira, clear skin is possible.
Thought it'd be bigger.
There's nothing I can't reach in my Subaru.
Introducing the all-new Subaru Outback. Love, it's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
You again? Gorilla Glue. Of course.
Water activated. Original Gorilla Glue expands into the materials to form an incredibly strong bond for the toughest jobs on planet Earth.
Hey, Anthony.
Hey, Melissa. How cool is it that you can save up to $35 when you open a Walmart credit card account this holiday season?
Super cool.
Hey, with all those great savings, you're going to need a bigger stocking.
I'm way ahead of you. What?
What?
You'll get $25 back when you spend $75 on your new account. Then you can get another $10 when you spend $75
more. Santa loves me.
How does he feel about me?
He thinks you're okay.
Walmart. More ways to Christmas joy.
I want to find one girl to help my brand to go on.
I'm excited. I'm going to work for DBF.
I'm going to kill this thing.
There's a lot of responsibility.
Maybe more than
we were prepared for.
This is an opportunity. Don't blow it.
House of DBF, Sunday at 10, only on E!
Currently in our area, 80 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds, low 66. Winds light and variable. Friday, partly cloudy sky. Friday night, a few clouds from time to time, low 66. Winds north-northeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
See the weather like never before.
Look at this!
Listen to that!
Amazing starts here. The Weather Channel Mornings.
Now, this is how you enjoy the season's first snowfall. The horses at this petting zoo in North Dakota are kicking up their heels, or hooves, while the flakes fly. Now, someone else is out in the fluffy white snow today, and that's our meteorologist, Kate Parker.
I'm here on Copper Mountain. We have a lot of folks up here skiing on some man-made snow. We're going to tell you how they're making the snow and how you can be prepared for the upcoming winter season. That's all coming up.
She gets the great trips, right?
She does.
We're stuck in the studio.
We'll hopefully get some snow at some point here. I've asked for a snow machine
for us
on that side of the studio so we can play while Kate's playing.
Hey, thanks for staying with us here on Weather Center Live. I'm Dave Schwartz.
And I'm Alex Wilson. We're all about winter today. Some of us have already felt the brunt of an early winter storm, but there is more coming.
Along with the snow, there's more cold air on the way. We're going to take a look at the next 1-2 punch by Mother Nature. And we're going to get you ready for winter weather. Alex starts us off with a look at what's in store for the Midwest, Great Lakes, Northeast.
Yeah, Great Lakes and Northeast where we want to focus first because these are the areas that actually have a storm this week. You're dealing with some of it right now, but it's primarily rain. However, winter alerts have been posted, winter storm warnings, winter storm watches, and winter weather advisories from northern New York into northern New England. And this rain will eventually transition over to snow for some of those spots, really interior parts of the Northeast and New England. Right now, we've got the rain from West Virginia all the way to Maine. Into tomorrow, though, that moisture has continued to be pulled north as that storm system strengthens. We've also got an extra kick from an upper-level disturbance. We're going to see some of that colder air on the backside of this system filter in, and that's going to allow for that transition from rain to snow. So tonight, rain and snow showers where you see that pink shading. Tomorrow, notice much more blue shows up on the map, and that's because we begin to see the snow showers breaking out across parts of West Virginia, even eastern Tennessee, western North Carolina, but all the way up into western central New York, northern New York, and then northern parts of Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine. Northern Maine, that's where you're going to be the big winner as far as the snowfall accumulations go. 8 to 12 inches possible through Saturday morning. 1 to 3 inches for parts of northern central and western New York, also northern parts of Vermont and New Hampshire. Most of the winners, though, coming into the state of Maine. Burlington, it's rain and snow for you to end the week with a high of 39 for your Friday, low 40s, and we'll keep the cloud cover, but it will be dry Saturday and Sunday. Dave?
You know, Alex, this is a little too cold for too long this early in the season. Now, here we are. There's Denver. It's a beautiful day in Denver. Big changes coming up early next week. Chicago, it's just cold. It's cold. Philadelphia, soupy. And here in Atlanta, temperature in the low 70s this afternoon. Obviously, Denver and Atlanta, the big winners. But I'll tell you, every one of those cities, and perhaps yours, is going to get involved in another Arctic outbreak here in the, well, now second week of November. That's when it's going to be happening. Right now, it's cold enough. I mean, in Wausau, Wisconsin, you walk outside right now, the wind chill value is 27. I mean, this is Mother Nature and Old Man Winter in cahoots. They're playing hardball with us. So we just have to be ready for it. That's the way it's going to be. You know, what are you going to set your thermostat to at home? You know, these heating bills, wow, this early in the season. And here comes another shot right here. This is for tomorrow. That comes south tomorrow. Then, late in the weekend, this comes southward. All right, so it's actually a one punch. Tomorrow, the second punch, there it comes. And then the very cold air moves into the United States. Sunday spreads across from the Rockies eastward, from Maine to Florida, by late next week. So there it comes. Arctic outbreak. What is this? The second real big one so far this season. Highs 10 to 20 degrees below average. We've seen what those numbers can be like. 27 below freezing in all these cities for highs on Monday. Then it spreads into St. Louis. 43 is 14 degrees below average, and it settles into the Ohio and Tennessee valleys by the time we get to Wednesday. That, my friend, is cold for the second week of November. Look at your highs. Our average high in Minneapolis, 47. What would the average be here? About 30 for next week? So let's get ready for it. Let's get prepped for it. Here's Alex.
Thank you, Dave. Today is our winter prep rally, and meteorologist Kate Parker is at the Copper Mountain Ski Lodge near Denver, Colorado, to tell us how ski resorts depend on man-made snow when Mother Nature isn't providing any.
So I'm here in Copper Mountain, and all of this snow that you see around me is man-made. We did get a little bit of snow here this week, but they are having to use these snow machines almost around the clock. I say almost because in the afternoons, it's too warm to run them. We've got too much sunlight. The temperature's too high. At night, they are working hard. They are working overtime, though, while those temperatures are cool. Here's the bottom line. It takes a whole lot to turn water into winter. Mammoth Mountain, California. Jackson Hole, Wyoming. And right here in Copper Mountain, Colorado. Ski resorts aren't waiting on winter. They need snow now. And when it doesn't come from the clouds, it's born here in Copper Mountain's pump rooms.
Don't wait for Mother Nature. We do it ourselves.
For snowmaking manager Mike Looney, the process starts with water. A lot of water. It takes 180,000 gallons to cover 1 acre with a foot of snow. And because there's very little natural snow right now, some of these pumps are running around the clock.
This is snowmaking in the air.
Copper Mountain has 700 of these snow guns. Inside here, the water is atomized into tiny particles. Compressed air shoots out those droplets that freeze as snow before they hit the ground. Copper Mountain likes to have an 18-inch snow base before they open for the season. But in order to do that, the weather has to cooperate. And something very important, the wet bulb temperature.
The ambient temperature mixed with the relative humidity. We fire our stuff up at 28 degrees wet bulb.
The wet bulb reading tells Looney when the water droplets will properly freeze as snow. The colder and drier the air, the better. But with the right wet bulb temperature, it's possible to make snow even when the temperature is above freezing.
It can be as high as 37 degrees ambient, and we can make snow.
Man can't completely copy Mother Nature's beauty. Take a look under a microscope. The natural snow on the left forms in flakes. The man-made snow looks like little snowballs.
A grain of sand would be one of these particulates. It's consistent, it is stable, it's safe.
And when Mother Nature doesn't do its job, the snowmaking team at Copper Mountain can pick up the slack, creating the perfect powder for skiers all season long. So the U.S. Olympic ski team is up on the mountain as we speak, trying to get ready for their next competition on some man-made snow. Here's the deal. We need Mother Nature's help. So we're going to go back to the Weather Channel and see what you guys can do for us.
And you know our winter weather team is working on that. We want to take you to Miami, though, right now. Take a look at that. Sunshine, sand, surf, palm trees. Ah, little mental vacation for us. All right, let's talk about some rain coming in time for the weekend. Not what you want to hear. You're thinking, all right, yeah, you've showed me that great view, but it's Thursday. I'm at work. By the weekend, things are changing. Right now, not much at all on the radar, but the system bringing rain to parts of South Texas is going to head east as we get into the weekend, and that means the rain is coming for parts of Florida. Front stalled across the Gulf states, and that strong upper system moving east will increase the chances for rain as we get into our Saturday and then Sunday. So wet weather coming to Florida for the weekend. Saturday night, rain through parts of northern and central Florida with showers really everywhere else. On Sunday, good chance of rain Jacksonville to Orlando, even all the way down towards Miami. And the heaviest rainfall totals this weekend will come in the central part of the state. That's where we could see 1 to 2 inches, up to an inch possible everywhere else. We're back after a look at your local on the 8th.
Currently in our area, 79 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds, low 66. Winds light and variable. Friday, partly cloudy skies, high 80. Winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Friday night, a few clouds from time to time, low 66. Winds north-northeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
On Terrence Knighton's truck are engineered to be Bridgestone's best SUV tires, and now they have an 80,000-mile treadwear warranty.
Guess we're gonna be here a while.
First time on a treadmill?
What are you saying?
I'm just saying.
With an 80,000-mile treadwear warranty, the Dueler tires are Bridgestone's best SUV tires. Go to BridgestoneTire.com to find a Bridgestone dealer near you.
Remember the hassle of vacuuming before the Dyson DC59 Motorhead? Before our direct drive cleaner head increased brush power to out-clean the 5 best-selling full-size vacuums across carpets and hard floors without the hassle of a cord.
Mm-hmm.
those in need. Bring in a coat to Burlington. Get 10% off our everyday low prices.
There is no car in this accident. Because there was no accident. Volvo's most advanced accident avoidance systems ever. The future of safety from the company that has always brought you the future of safety. Give the gift of Volvo this season, and we'll give you your first month's payment on us.
Today we're getting record snowfall.
Radars indicate there's been flooding throughout the area.
We're getting hail the size of golf balls.
Maglite. Turn your light on, America.
Hark how the bells, sweet silver bells, all seem to say, folk care away from everywhere.
Chex Party Mix. Easy 15-minute homemade recipes you just pop in a microwave, like caramel chocolate drizzles. Happier holidays. Chex Party Mix.
If you're on Medicare, remember, the open enrollment period is here. The time to choose your Medicare coverage begins October 15th and ends December 7th. So call to enroll in a plan that could give you the benefits and stability you're looking for. An AARP Medicare Complete Plan insured through UnitedHealthcare. What makes it complete? It can combine Medicare Parts A and B, which is your hospital and doctor coverage, with Part D prescription drug coverage and more. All in one simple plan. For a low monthly premium, or in some areas, no plan premium at all. An AARP Medicare Complete Plan offers you benefits like an annual physical, preventive screenings, and immunizations for a $0 copay. You'll also have access to a local network of doctors and much more. When you enroll in an AARP Medicare Complete Plan insured through UnitedHealthcare, your benefits could also include routine vision and hearing coverage and prescription drug coverage accepted nationwide. And with the Pharmacy Saver program, you can get prescriptions for as little as $1.50 at thousands of pharmacies and retail locations like these. Now is the time to look at your options. Start getting the benefits of an AARP Medicare Complete Plan insured through UnitedHealthcare. We've been helping Medicare beneficiaries for over 30 years. We'll connect you with the right people and programs, offer smart ways to save, and give you the tools to help make your healthcare experience a positive one. Remember, open enrollment ends December 7th. Call UnitedHealthcare today about an AARP Medicare Complete Plan. You can even enroll right over the phone or visit us online. Don't wait. Call now.
Ready for some Thursday night football?
Oh, they moved. They started the video.
Oh,
if you would have seen it.
You know,
we had some good stuff.
It's the Bengals and the Browns tonight.
Bengals and Browns tonight, and our own Paul Goodlow shows you what impact the weather could have on tonight's action. He's got a pretty good streak going.
Not him again.
Well, tonight is a kickoff to week 10 in the NFL. A battle in Ohio, the Browns versus the Bengals. The forecast tonight, definitely a player in tonight's game. Look at this, rain all game long. Temperatures stay in the 40s, and the wind is howling all game long. So how will this impact the players in the field? First thing I want to look at is the stats for the quarterbacks. Well, Hoyer, starting over Johnny Football, decent yards so far this year, and Andy Dalton not doing too bad, but again, I definitely give the edge to Hoyer there until I go deeper into the stats. In cold weather games, his numbers are actually going down. Hoyer's are. And now in terms of rain games, he's played two games, averaging only 52 yards in passing. Not impressive. Now, Andy Dalton, on the other hand, he's played 19 games in cold weather, and his numbers are pretty decent. But take a look at this. In the rain, his numbers averaged over 250 yards passing. So pretty good in the rain. I definitely give the quarterback edge to the Bengals on this one. Okay, now what about wide receivers? For the Browns, top two receivers here, no games played in the rain. Two games here, only averaging 33 yards. Not impressive at all. Now for the Bengals, well, decent numbers here for Sanu. He's come on this year, but hey, what about AJ Green? Two games in the rain, averaging over 110 yards. Definitely the advantage for the receivers. Also going to the Bengals here as well. Now, Running backs. Bernard, he is out tonight, not expected to play. So I definitely give that edge to the Browns here with Ben Tate. And what about defenses? Well, also, tonight, we're talking about the Browns. They average 140 yards giving up on the ground on defense. But the same thing, the same average for the Bengals. They also average giving up 140 yards on the ground. So based on the stats, how they perform in the weather, and tonight's forecast, I am predicting a win by the Cincinnati Bengals in tonight's game. Back to you.
Paul, you're like the Chris Berman on the Weather Channel.
Amazing.
Well, maybe you've got plans to throw the football around with the kids this weekend, or maybe do a little early season Christmas shopping. Here's what Mother Nature has in store for you, my friend, my young friend. Huh? Your 7-day forecast. Starting with tomorrow, Friday, and we got all the colors of the palette here in the Northeast because there's going to be low-level rains and high-elevation snows. And that goes all the way down to the southern Appalachians again. This won't be as quite as prolific in the southern part of it, but up here in upstate New York, the northern Adirondacks, northern mountains of New England, 5 to 10 inches of snow. Now, that's one storm. Let's get as it gets out of here on Saturday. In comes the second storm into the Great Lakes, a mix of rain and snow. And look at this, snow in behind it. That's the third storm. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4. Sunday, a storm comes into the Pacific Northwest. No great shakes there, just some rain force in Seattle, maybe Portland. And then it gets into the cold air. And look at that, a wide swath of light to moderate snow from the Rockies all the way to Michigan. Well, that's going to continue here. It's going to come down the Front Range. Denver goes from 64 Monday to 39 on Tuesday with some snow maybe Monday night. Then the storm consolidates in the middle of the country. Here in Wisconsin, could be some significant snow. Northern lower and upper Michigan, and some showers and thundershowers on Tuesday from the Ohio Valley to the lower Mississippi Valley. Then we head to Wednesday. The storm heads to the East Coast, rain for New York City and Boston, and then the cold air makes it all the way to the Gulf Coast and East Coast by Thursday. Back to you, Alex.
Thank you, Dave. Well, the biggest weather concerns on the horizon pose two different threats. One will have you looking like it's winter. The other will have you feeling like the season. Storm specialist Dr. Greg Postel pinpoints who will struggle with each. We leave you with a look at New York. There's the ice skaters. Taylor Swift's new New York song is just in my head now.
Nearly 7 million clients. How did Edward Jones get so big?
Let me just put this away. Could you teach our kids that trick?
By not acting that way. It's how Edward Jones makes sense of investing.
Hershey's spreads. Bring the delicious taste of Hershey's chocolate to anything. Everything. With Hershey's spreads, the possibilities are delicious.
This is a map of the pressure points on my feet.
I had flat feet. I learned where the stress was at the Dr. Scholl's Foot Mapping Center. Then I got my number, which matched the custom fit orthotic inserts with the right support.
Go to drscholls.com for locations and save $10.
I'm a believer.
Currently in our area, 79 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds, low 66. Winds light and variable. Friday, partly cloudy skies. High 80. Winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Friday night, a few clouds from time to time. Low 66. Winds north-northeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Let's get a head start on the holidays. Let's open something before Christmas. Not that. Those. And of course, a whole lot of these. Let's make merry, along with a few other things. Deck out that. Save all these and spread more of this. That's how to holiday. Let's do this. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Trade in your old lights and get up to $5 off the latest LEDs.
Fiber One now makes cookies. Find them in the cookie aisle.
Making coffee?
Yeah. Enough for two.
Try four, buddy.
I'll take a dark roast.
Chai tea, please.
Honey, text the man what you want.
French vanilla. Make it strong.
The all-new Keurig 2.0 is here. Brew for one, brew for all.
Hurry, there's a hot offer for heartburn sufferers. Now try Zantac free at ZantacOffers.com. Hurry, it's free this week only. No pill relieves heartburn faster. Get Zantac free at ZantacOffers.com.
Just like an interception. I bet you didn't see this one coming.
Up your game with the new Fritos.
You're driving along, having a perfectly nice day, when out of nowhere, a pickup truck slams into your brand new car. One second, it wasn't there, and the next second, boom, you had your first accident. Now you have to make your first claim. So you talk to your insurance company, and boom, you're blindsided for a second time. They won't give you enough money to replace your brand new car. Don't those people know you're already shaken up?
Liberty Mutual's new car replacement will pay for the entire value of your car, plus depreciation. Call 1-844-251-3579. And for drivers with accident forgiveness, Liberty Mutual won't raise your rates due to your first accident. Switch to Liberty Mutual Insurance and you could save up to $423. Call Liberty Mutual for a free quote today at 1-844-251-3579. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Call Humana now at 1-866-680-4971.
Every Sunday, a new tale of weather legend. American Supernatural, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Sounds like it.
New video into us right now, and it's a reminder of what wet pavement can produce. It's caused a rollover collision in Corpus Christi this morning. Now, the man driving this utility truck says he was going just a bit too fast on the wet road. Well, he lost control and his truck flipped over. A passenger in the truck suffered minor injuries. Now it's time to turn to the lab. We're back to hard weather, and here's Alex and a friend.
That's right. I'm out in the lab with storm specialist Dr. Greg Postel, and we've been picking some cities to highlight that to really just show the trend for the eastern half of the country as we get into the next week, this time Atlanta.
Yeah, it's going to get cold for most people east of the Rockies next week, and it's going to last more than just a couple days.
Right.
Let's now pick a city in the south. We did New York, Chicago, kind of the same theme. But Atlanta, this is a map of the forecast temperatures. So for the next couple of days, we're going to be bobbing around average. There's the date on the bottom. So it's November 5th all the way through the 19th of November. So we're looking pretty far out in the future. But look what happens by about, what, your birthday, Alex?
Yeah, November 10th.
Yeah.
Right, so here, we're going to peak on the 10th.
Right.
And then it's just downhill from
and
there.
And then it's downhill from there. So, yeah, you'll have one good time, and then it's like,
I'm just going to have that one good day. And then I'm just older.
But you know what? It's going to stay cold, exactly, for a long time. And I put a lot of shading on here, showing you other model scenarios. But you know what? I think you can kind of see that most of the shading is below that average line, suggesting that mm-hmm. there's a consensus that's growing in the models that it's going to be cold for a long time in the country.
Right.
But I would say that even now, as the days progress, we'll be able to move even more of that shading on the below side down here. It's going to stick around for a while. It's got some legs.
It does. What was notable about the last one was it was And just a little taste, and then it's
out
of here.
It was like a day. You didn't even know it came. It was like a day and it was gone. This cold outbreak is much different in the Southeast.
All right. Well, and it's got a tropical connection. We head over to the Western Pacific. Remember that superstorm Nuri, or super typhoon? It was a superstorm, sort of.
Yeah.
But now, kind of working its way or influencing a really powerful storm.
Yes. It's still got that tropical energy with it, and it's influencing the jet stream. It's tangled up with it, and this is a very strong jet stream across the North Pacific. Very stormy times out there right now, in part related to the interaction with this tropical cyclone. But look at these, from really Japan all the way across the Pacific. In places, the wind is over 200 miles per hour at about 30,000 feet up at the jet stream level. So that's a really wiggly, windy pattern up there, and you know it has downstream consequences over North America.
Exactly. So as we set this into play, we'll start with Alaska. You know, this is still part of the U.S. They're going to get the brunt of this system, at least as far as the stormy aspect goes. We'll get the cold.
That's exactly right. And this very big storm, which has some of its history tied directly to Typhoon Nuri, but also it's got that strong jet stream working with it. There is the answer, we think, something like that on Saturday, with a big, windy winter storm that is not just characterized by sustained winds of perhaps close to hurricane force over a very broad area of the North Pacific. We also have some very high waves that are going to be part of the puzzle, too. There are going to be some waves in there that I think are going to be closer to 100 feet than 50 feet in places across the Bering Sea.
Oh, this one's a beast. And you know, when it gets attention in the Weather Channel offices, it means business. And this one has been doing just that. So now we talk about how this impacts us in the U.S., or at least the lower 48, because Alaska gets the brunt of the system, at least the Aleutian Islands, but we get the cold.
Yeah, we get the cold, and the reason why we get the cold is because they get the warm. When someone gets the warm way up north, where the cold air normally is, the cold air gets shoved out of its origin and it heads south. And this is what's going to happen. This is an Arctic high pressure system sliding south on Monday and early next week. This is a real Arctic outbreak that's coming in November style. It's not going to be as cold as those ones that we've seen in January, but still way below average temperatures, perhaps 20 degrees below average will be common, not just for one day, but maybe for 2 days. And notice how it grows in scale. The blues expand and they go south. And this is really just the beginning. I think Wednesday is just the beginning because it could last a lot longer. And I want to point out that some of the models early next week are bringing some kind of snow across parts of the upper Midwest and Great Lakes. Several inches are possible. We'll have much more on that in the coming days as the new data rolls in.
There's a tease. We're sticking with you for more on that. Thank you so much, Dr. Postel. Dave, back to you.
And we're tracking more than winter weather threats. Tornado caught on tape. And what makes this spinning fury even more stunning? Where it struck? Why is it so surprising? As Weather Center Live rolls on.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds, low 66. Winds light and variable. Friday, partly cloudy skies, high 80. Winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Friday night, a few clouds from time to time, low 66. Winds north-northeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
From the Weather Channel headquarters in Atlanta, you're watching Weather Center Live. And look out, here it comes, an Arctic invasion like we haven't felt since last winter. It's about to turn very cold for a very big part of the country. When it arrives and the big drop in temperatures coming up. Hi, everyone. Thanks for joining us. I'm Kelly Cass.
And I'm Chris Warren. Before that big Arctic invasion arrives, millions will get a 1-2 punch of cold air and snow. You can kind of consider it a little appetizer before the frozen entree.
For some of you, a tasty treat. Others are like, too soon, right? Yeah. Let's show you what's going on the radar right now, because we do actually have some severe weather to talk about, actually. As a matter of fact, moving through southern New Jersey at this time, and we also have plenty of rain kind of swirling around an area of low pressure, a chilly rain at that across lower Michigan, and even mixing with a little bit of snow up here in the higher elevations of the Adirondacks. So let's kind of zoom on in and show you what we're talking about as far as severe weather is concerned. Right here in southern New Jersey, this storm moving rather quickly toward the east at about 50 miles per hour. It could be producing some very strong wind gusts over 60 miles per hour. And this does include Atlantic City, New Jersey. So we've got Atlantic, Cape May, Cumberland counties under that severe thunderstorm warning. Again, this storm is moving very quickly toward the east, just leaving the Delaware area and sliding on over towards southern New Jersey. So beware of that. Otherwise, we've got the chilly rain up across upstate New York and some snow as well. By the way, we have storms going on in parts of New Jersey where, even though you're not under a severe warning, it still looks pretty rough out there. There's a live look at Seaside Heights, New Jersey. And yeah, looking pretty gloomy out there on the boardwalk and very cloudy indeed. But again, you are not included in that severe thunderstorm warning. Back into Michigan we go. There's that chilly rain I was speaking of. 48 degrees in Detroit with that light rain coming down. We've got 45 in Saginaw. And here in Cincinnati, of course, we're watching your radar very closely. We've got some football going on later on tonight as your Bengals are taking on the Browns. Temperatures in the mid-40s right now. And for kickoff later on at 8:25, it looks like there will be some issues with the wet weather. And even that wind is going to be picking up at times, gusting as high as 20 miles per hour. Chris, over to you.
All right, Kelly, and it's going to be cold and even a chance for some snow as well throughout parts of the Northeast and New England here. As we look at where the winter alerts are right now, where you're going to have to be on the lookout for some snow, parts of upstate New York into Vermont, New Hampshire, and parts of Maine, once again, going to see that chance for some snow, and we'll see some snow in some areas. This is this evening at 5 o'clock. This is the computer depiction of where the rain and the snow will be. The rain in the green, put this in motion. The blue that we're going to see, this is where there's going to be snow. So pockets of it, Saranac Lake, eventually overnight hours while it's still dark into the morning, chance for snow. And then mid-morning, right along the Canadian border here, that's where you're going to have the best chance for some snow. Now into the afternoon tomorrow, snow throughout parts of Maine, and you have that cooler air dropping down. So any showers that linger during the day tomorrow into the evening hours, likely to be snow in many of the northern locations. But really, once you get into the afternoon and evening, that threat for snow does go down quite a bit. Any precipitation with the system moving out. When it's all said and done, the higher snowfall amounts, in some cases close to a foot, will be very isolated in the higher elevations, the northern locations here, and then a chance for more widespread 3 to 5 and then 1 to 3 inch snowfall totals throughout parts of upstate New York. But again, more of a spotty situation. It's not going to be for everyone, mainly the northern locations. That's the snow. Now we're looking at that cold. Into tomorrow, you're going to have that dip of the jet stream. The weekend, a little bit of a break from the cold. Temperatures come up a little bit. And then later in the weekend, another dip in the jet stream cools things down once again. Kelly?
And Chris, as we mentioned off the top, some of the coldest air of the season is about to spread south all the way from Canada, and it could enhance that chance of snow for many. Our storm specialist Carl Parker is covering that part of the story, joining us from the lab right now. Hey, Carl.
Hey, Kelly. There's a lot going into this, and much of it is just seasonal. So let's take a look at where this cold air is now building. As you know, we're getting a lower sun angle at this time of the year, and there's a part of the North Pole around the Arctic Circle that's not getting any sun at all. So it's very easy for cold air masses to build there. Then you've got a lot of snow cover in northern Canada, and that allows those cold air masses to remain cold as they travel southward. Acts like a refrigerator, and so this cold air is going to come right down from Canada and drop into the northern plains and then spread through a lot of the east into the early and middle part of next week. But that's not the only factor. Another part of this is this incredibly powerful storm that's going to come into western Alaska, into the Aleutian Islands, which are right there with hurricane force winds and tremendous seas, 50-foot waves. And that storm is actually sharing some DNA with a typhoon, a former typhoon there that was near Japan. That'll be lifting up and bringing a lot of warm air along with it. And that warm air is actually reshaping the temperature and pressure profiles there in Alaska and western Canada and helping to drive that cold air even farther southward. So sort of aiding and abetting this cold air outbreak. So with that in mind, let's take a look at the departures going into next Monday. Looking for high temperatures in the 20s in North and South Dakota, about 31 in Minneapolis, definitely ahead of schedule for this time of the year. And then as we go into the plains, big changes on the way for you. It's going to be really warm on Sunday and then quite chilly by Tuesday. North Platte, 31 degrees. That's minus 20 relative to average. And Oklahoma City topping out at 46, we think, on Tuesday. And then down into the south, and these numbers may be a little conservative. It could be even colder than that. Talking about 54 in Atlanta and 37 degrees in Cleveland. And there's a lot of model confidence about this. And I want to show you the plots here looking at individual cities. So you'll notice as we go out in time towards the right that you see these are all the ensemble members of the European model. You notice that this area gets wider as we go out in time. So that's the increased uncertainty that you see with time. So you look for the average here, and generally you've got all these members that are well below average, indicating that it will be quite cold going into the early part of next week, starting on the 11th there in Chicago and then right through the 13th, and then some moderation towards the end of the week. And we see something very similar in New York, a very strong signal indicating that it's going to get chilly indeed there by the 13th in New York, and then again some moderation as we move towards the weekend. So a big shot of Arctic air on the way, Kelly, and a sure sign of the times. Over to you.
Sending shivers up and down my spine as we speak. Carl, thank you so much. As winter approaches, so does the snow, like this beautiful snowfall from earlier this week in Maine.
But you may have heard that no two snowflakes are alike. In today's brainstorm, we explain whether this is actually true. That's coming up after your local on the 8s here on Weather Center Live.
If you have Medicare Part D, you could be at the corner of I'm throwing away money and I had no idea. Well, Walgreens has your back. Our expert pharmacists make it easy for you to save on your prescriptions so you can keep your money where it belongs. Swing by Walgreens, where you could save even more with Medicare prescription copays as low as $0 at the corner of happy and healthy.
Nature Valley Crunchy Granola Bars give you energy from one-third of your daily whole grains. So one-third of this commercial is dedicated to what you could do with all that energy. Energy to take the road less traveled.
Rich, chewy caramel rolled up in smooth milk chocolate.
All aboard.
Rolo, get your smooth on.
It's just freaking me out.
If you miss this Sunday night on the Weather Channel,
this is crazy.
You'll never know how twisted weather can be.
Is it real? Yeah, it's real.
Wicked Weather Sundays with Strangest Weather on Earth and American Super Natural. Every Sunday night at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds, low 66. Winds light and variable. Friday, partly cloudy skies. High 80. Winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Friday night, a few clouds from time to time. Low 66. Winds north-northeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Today, a Weather Channel first, the Winter Weather Prep Rally, a day dedicated to prepping and surviving winter's worst.
Best advice, try not to travel.
In the morning,
you've got our winter weather outlook.
And at night,
this is an incredibly deadly time of year.
Yeah, it's brutal.
The Winter Weather Prep Rally continues all day on the Weather Channel.
Last winter, it was so cold.
We were not prepared.
So this year, we went to Burlington. Burlington's got every kind of coat you can imagine at really great prices. A lot of bang for our buck.
Freezing cold winter,
bring it on.
Andrew, Rita, Sandy. Meet Chris, Jackie, Joe. Minor damage or major disaster. When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
The Dueler tires on Terrence Knighton's truck are engineered to be Bridgestone's best SUV tires, and now they have an 80,000-mile treadwear warranty.
Guess we're going to be here a while.
First time on a treadmill?
What are you saying?
I'm just saying.
With an 80,000-mile treadwear warranty, the Dueler tires are Bridgestone's best SUV tires. Go to BridgestoneTire.com to find a Bridgestone dealer near you.
Hi. Are we still on for tomorrow?
Tomorrow.
Quick look at the weather. Nice today, beautiful tomorrow.
Tomorrow is full of promise.
We come back tomorrow.
And we promise to keep it that way. Driven to preserve the environment, CSX moves a ton of freight nearly 450 miles on 1 gallon of fuel.
What a day.
Can't wait till tomorrow.
Snowflakes are a symbol of winter. They're also a symbol of individuality. But some wonder if it's possible that no two snowflakes are alike. A question made for the Weather Channel. Here's Sam Champion.
A snowflake begins to form when a water droplet freezes around an atmospheric dust particle. This becomes what's called a condensation nucleus and can be just 4 millionths of an inch in diameter. That's 1,000 times smaller than the thickness of a single sheet of paper. In sub-freezing temperatures, the water molecules crystallize around this speck of dust. When this crystal becomes heavier than the surrounding air, it begins to fall. During its approximate 15 to 45 minute trip to the ground, this new snowflake travels through changes in humidity, temperature, and wind. As the flake adds water molecules, each of these atmospheric factors contribute differently to form a unique six-arm symmetrical pattern. For example, flakes that fall through cold and dry conditions typically have simpler, compact shapes, while those falling through warmer, more humid conditions often have very complex dendrites, or arms. Now, when taking into account the countless subtle variations of weather each crystal can experience, the odds of two snowflakes being exactly the same shape are astronomical. Under a microscope, an average-sized snowflake can easily have more than 100 distinguishable features. And even though every year it's been estimated that 1 septillion snow crystals fall to the ground, that's a one with 24 zeros, we'll still likely never see two that are identical.
You will have some snow in your forecast as we check out the next 7 days. Not only snow, we're going to be tracking some very cold air, the coldest of the season. It's going to be sliding all the way down toward the south. So enjoy the next couple of days, relatively speaking, because 47 in Chicago, that's not bad compared to what we're going to see next week. You see a few showers up there across the northern portions of Minnesota. And yes, we will have some snow across the interior sections of the Northeast as we head into the day tomorrow. And then as we get into Saturday, it gets a little more interesting with that Arctic front beginning to work its way down from Canada. Note your high temperature. Minneapolis, only 39 degrees. Chicago, we're in the low 40s. We got the rain in the forecast across much of Ohio, western New York State, including western Pennsylvania as well. New York and Boston, temperatures in the 40s, while Atlanta, enjoy that balmy 63 degrees. Here we go, Sunday. Still not too bad across the south, even though we'll have some rain in Florida. Here comes the snow and the cold working its way through the Great Lakes. Green Bay hosting the Bears on Sunday night. It's going to be a chilly one for that. You'll see the snow is going to continue across the plains and the upper Midwest as we head towards Monday. Tuesday, we follow the front. approaching the south, and that's going to send our temperatures down. Note Atlanta 54 for high on Wednesday and even turning colder on Thursday.
Winter Prep Rally is brought to you by Duracell, trusted to outlast the storm.
Okay, Patrick, one more stop.
Let's go base, shark, blitz.
Base, shark, blitz.
When the game's on the line.
Okay, this is for the game.
The NFL trusts Duracell Quantum to power their game day communication.
Flag 19, hot!
Abort, abort, he's keeping it!
Duracell Quantum lasts up to 35% longer than the competition.
There is no car in this accident. Because there was no accident. Volvo's most advanced accident avoidance systems ever. The future of safety from the company that has always brought you the future of safety. Give the gift of Volvo this season, and we'll give you your first month's payment on us.
Shopping online is as easy as it gets. Wouldn't it be great if hiring plumbers, carpenters, and even piano tuners were just as simple? Thanks to Angie's List, now it is. We've made hiring anyone from a handyman to a dog walker as simple as a few clicks. Buy their services directly at angieslist.com. No more calling around. No more hassles. Start shopping from a list of top-rated providers today.
Angie's List is revolutionizing local service again. Visit angieslist.com today.
Oh, yeah, that's going down. Come on, let's get some rocks back.
Health can change in a minute. So CVS Health is changing healthcare, making it more accessible and affordable with over 900 locations for walk-in medical care and more on the way. Minute Clinic, another innovation from CVS Health, because health is everything.
Put on your thinking caps. Evaporation rate equals 700 times the mean temperature divided by 100 minus the latitude plus 15 times temperature minus dew point temperature divided by 80 minus temperature.
Esurance was born online, which means fewer costs, which saves money. Their customer experience is virtually paperless, which saves paper, which saves money. They have smart online tools, so you only pay for what's right for you, which saves money. They settle claims quickly, which saves time, which saves money. They drive an all-hybrid claims fleet, which saves gas, which saves money. They were born online and built to save money, which means when they save, you save. Because that's how it should work in the modern world. Esurance, backed by Allstate. Click or call.
At City Furniture, every mattress we sell is covered by a 120-night security blanket. So you'll always know you got the best price on the best names in bedding. A Beauty Sleep Queen mattress set, just $4.99. Or buy a select Beautyrest hybrid mattress and get the box spring free. Plus, enjoy same-day delivery and no interest for 18 months. See for yourself in the showroom or at cityfurniture.com.
Trade commissions by going to tradeking.com/free1000 today. TradeKing.com.
All day today, a Weather Channel first, the Winter Weather Prep Rally, a day dedicated to prepping and surviving winter's worst.
Best advice, try not to travel.
In the morning,
you've got our winter weather outlook.
And at night,
this is an incredibly deadly time of year.
Yeah, it's brutal.
The Winter Weather Prep Rally continues all day on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 79 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds, low 66. Winds light and variable. Friday, partly cloudy skies. High 80. Winds north-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Friday night, a few clouds from time to time. Low 66. Winds north-northeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
here in the lab with storm specialist Carl Parker to explain a bomb over Alaska. Yeah. Dramatic word, but it's a meteorological bomb. It is very rare and very big. So let's get right down to what a bomb is and then what we're looking at and why we're talking about a bomb.
Well, a bomb is a system that becomes so strong so fast that the pressure drops out. It bombs out, as we say. And this storm is going to be among the strongest storms that we ever see. It's going to be way down there in terms of its central pressure. And that low pressure relates directly to how strong it is and how severe the impacts are going to be. And they're going to be severe. They're in an area where, fortunately, not a lot of people live. That westernmost island in Alaska, Attu, no one lives there. Actually, people travel there, but no one lives there. So here's part of the equation, and this is this typhoon that we've been watching moving near Japan, and there's not much to it right now.